Welcome to First Morgonauts Mostly Hackintosh Questions and Answers, so stay tuned. Hi, I'm Teresa from Morgonaut.cloud and I help people with Apple computers, Hackintosh builds, Linux servers, simply with computers. If you are new here, then please click that subscribe button and hit the bell next to it so you won't miss any of my future videos. I'm getting so many comments, I have really no chance to answer to you all. So that's why I decided to create this first edition of Morgonaut's Questions and Answers. So let's go straight to it. Uncle Brian M., it's easy to see that you really enjoy what you are doing. You are always smiling when you speak and that is very pleasant. I'm subscribed, really enjoy the content. Fantastic work on these videos. Cheers. Cheers. So, Mr. Uncle Brian, thank you very much for nice comment. You have no idea how many idiotic comments I'm getting every day. So each comment like this brings me back to my work and give me another effort to continue. So thank you. Next comment. Give me a second. Don Dewey. Morgonaut, can you point me to a Hackintosh build best for video editing? It's a comment under my 14-core iMac Pro killer. Darling, this is the best for video editing you can get, okay? Don Dewey, again, is this a good build for 4K video editing? Don, this is good even for 8K video editing. Thomas Suditomo, is ASRock Z370 ITX will work like a charm also? Tommy, I really cannot test each motherboard on the market. In my videos you can see only strictly components I personally tested and verified. So if you don't want any problems, stay with my recommendations, okay? Jeff Johnstone. Hi, wanted to make a Hackintosh for years but never had the time, patience, but your tutorials looks the easiest of all I have seen, so we'll give it a go. In the video it says the terminal script will be in the video description, but I can't find it. It might be my noobness, so I was hoping you could point me to it. Thanks. Jeff, in the video I say that the terminal command you can find in my video description. And what I did, so it's more understandable, I dedicated the whole video to this terminal command. And in this video description, you have the link to that whole video. So please, use your brain, think, breathe, and read my video description, okay? Andrew Hart, can you recommend a Wi-Fi Bluetooth module for the Z390 Designare, or does the included Wi-Fi work? No, the stock chips you can find on PC motherboards are not compatible. If you want to run Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, simply swap it for compatible one. Easy. By the way, I will do a video about one amazing all-in-one solution for Wi-Fi and Bluetooth for Hackintosh, so stay tuned. Onkar Tikale, please let me know where is the comment for terminal utilities. So again, as I told you 1 minute ago. Hani Farouk, where I can find a tutorial for installing Hackintosh High Sierra 10.13 on PC? My beginner's tutorial you can use not to install only Mojave, Catalina, but also High Sierra. So use my beginner's tutorial. Robert Palmer, Morgonaut, I went to your Patreon page, but it looks like the personal help option is sold out. Is there another way that you would be able to help me? I'm very new to this and just wanna make sure I do it right. Robert, they have still only 24 hours, so I have to limit the total number of my Patreons on each tier because I'm not able to handle 5,000 clients. So, if some tier or all tiers are sold out, then are sold out. I have no more time. So, people are coming in and going out of my Patreon on daily basis. So, if we will reload the page in hour tomorrow, probably some of the tiers will be available again. Titanica Official. Intento instalar usando tu blah blah blah. People, I really cannot speak all languages on this nice planet. So if you want to communicate with me, please use English as I do. Thank you. Arjit Mukherjee. Morgonaut, yes, keep making these amazing videos. Best wishes from India. Thank you. Again, Arit Mukherje. Thank you so much for the video. This really worked for me. Followed your instructions and updated to 10.14.6 without any issues. Yes, that's exactly how my vanilla builds are acting. Simply like a real Mac. But a lot of people have problems with their build to update. But that's not fault of my tutorial. It's fault of your installation and your preparation of your EFI. All my builds are working, so if it does not work for you, please watch that video again. Slowly, carefully, and then it simply must work if your system is clean vanilla installation. BLC. I would love to see a version with more reasonable RAM options. That kit is over 700 on Amazon. That's approaching Apple RAM prices. No, it's not. Mr. BLC. You bought the i9-9900K, you bought Radeon 7, and you would like to pair it with some cheap, crappy, slow memory? I don't understand that. If you want to get the most performance out of this build, it must be balanced. So if you have powerful CPU, powerful GPU, then you should also have powerful and more performant memory. That's exactly what I chose. But you are the free person, you can choose any memory you want. But don't expect amazing results out of it. Datarai Studio. Are you succeeded to connect iMac 2018 Plus display as second monitor via Thunderbolt 3? No, I don't have any iMac 2018. Sorry. You have to test it yourself. Jay Kumar. Hi, I have bought Intel i9 processor with Gigabyte Z390 Wi-Fi Pro motherboard. With 64GB RAM, I got Mojave installed in my system. All went right, but my onboard Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, LAN and USB 2 ports are not working. My current version, blah blah blah. That's exactly like all Hackintosh builds are acting on the beginning, before you will spend the time, in my case weeks, tweaking my EFI folders. So after all the time and tweaking, my builds are working perfectly. So LAN, USB, everything is working. So again, you chose to go the hard way. If you want to go the easiest way, go to the Morgonaut way. Archangel Antonio, that's nice. I noted none of this instruction involves Time Machine capsule. I love Time Machine passionately. Is this not as good as these others you mentioned? It's under my video called How to Backup Hackintosh. Yes, I never use and never will use Time Machine. Because Time Machine is not a proper backup in terms of clone. It's fancy nice UI for Windows users. They are amazed how it looks. But if you really want to have a bootable Hackintosh clone, use Carbon Copy Cloner, use the Super Duper, or my and other solutions I introduced in this video. Titus Tukan. Teresa, great idea and great work. Congrats. I have a question thought. How many SSDs did you use in total? Is this a 3YZ1 or 4YZ1? Did you stripe to by Z1 VDEVs, blah blah blah. Again, I say everything in that video. I'm using three ordinary SSDs hooked up together into a single RAID Z1 array, and then I'm using one single mechanical hard drive for backups and NAS features. Of course, you can choose as many disks you want. If you will choose four instead of three disks, you will gain even better performance or even better redundancy. It's completely up to you. By the way, in the video description, I listed in detail what components I use. Regan Gillespie. That video card on your list is not available anymore. Can I use something like a Vega? Oh, I think I've told so much about GPUs already in my videos. You can use any compatible, macOS compatible GPU you want. So from RX 560 up to for example my Radeon 7 over there. Ray, spank me mama. Okay, so people, I'm getting comments so stupid like this really each day on daily basis. What I do, I immediately ban those people. So please, if you are idiot, don't watch my videos and don't comment. We will save each other some time. Thank you. Bye bye. Volven Beats. Should BIOS settings for a Gigabyte motherboard be this video's recommended settings or your Gigabyte settings video? Is under my video built a perfect Hackintosh? So Volven Beats, why you better don't watch my video, which is called Gigabyte BIOS settings for Hackintosh. It's a good idea. Venomous Place. My flash drive isn't showing up in the startup disk. How to create macOS Mojave installer? Okay, so go to Disk Utilities and format it GUID and macOS Extended Journal. Hasman Husin. Hi, can you do budget Hackintosh, possibly Catalina? You don't watch my videos. I already done some budget Hackintosh build, so watch it. Steve Badolato. Can't wait to see if Catalina works on this build. Again, you don't watch my videos. I already done video about how this build is running on macOS Catalina. So watch it. Next comment. Oh, again, Steve Badolado. Can I run the LG 5K 27 Thunderbolt display that Apple sells off of this? Does Bluetooth work? Darling, I don't have any 27-inch LG blah 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 display. Try it. I cannot buy all displays because I'm getting these questions all the time. Does this display work? This one? I don't know. Probably. Maybe not. Maybe yes. Does Bluetooth work? Of course. On all my builds, everything is working. Next question. Matt Jabari. Am I blind? Here is my Hackintosh components. Can you direct me to the video that has the EFI specs? Z3 Designare, i9-9300K, Samsung EVO, Corsair, blah blah blah. Darling, that's exactly the specification of my so-called 14-core iMac Pro killer. And in each of my video descriptions, you can find what? Link to my tweaked and prepared EFI. So please, read video description, okay? Thanks. The Random Techlet. Is it possible to send you my Mac G5 case for you to build for me? Or any instructions or link to help me, please? No, I don't do it commercially. All the builds I have here, rebuilded the G5 cases, I have done myself and only for my personal use. It is really quite difficult and time-consuming, but you can find on internet quite fine resources, so search for it. Matt Jabari. Where are your EFIs you mentioned in this video? Oh God, so again, please read video description. In each video description under some of my builds, you can find link to my EFI. Read video description. MattinZD, is RX 516 native support? I mean plug and play, or it needs configuration? I want to buy dedicated GPU and don't know what to buy. RX 560, 70, 80, blah, 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 blah. The main thing is plug and play. Plug and play it is on real Macs. If you want to put it into your Hackintosh, you need to tweak your EFI configuration. But yes, in the terms when you tweak it, then it's plug and play. Gabby, you are amazing. I'm so inspired to build my own Hackintosh. I own an iMac, but I still want to build something more powerful. Thank you so much for these videos. Okay. Manit Sony, how much Geekbench on Radeon 7 you are getting? Geekbench on macOS is crippled. Don't trust it. I mean the GPU benchmark. The CPU are fine. So if you will compare, if you will do benchmark of any GPU like Vega Frontier Edition or the Radeon 7, on the macOS you will get terrible results. If you will redo the same benchmark on Windows, you will get amazing results. So it's not the problem of the card, it's problem of the Geekbench version for the macOS. So don't use it, don't trust it. Enrico DeMarci, sorry. Always click like before it starts, never regret it. That's nice, okay, thank you. Dobromir Rainov, subscribe, love at first sight. Okay, Dobromir, I have also already bad eyes and I need new glasses. Think about it, but thank you. It was a bad joke from me, sorry. Timothy Frazier, has anyone had an issue with Gigabyte Z3 Designare BIOS version F6? I would like to hackintosh this monster of a machine by trying a vanilla install gets an error, because that guy is not using my BIOS preset, my BIOS update, and my tweaked EFI. That's when you go into troubles. Dr. Dragon, love your wits, thank you. Thank you too. Matthew Robertson, I am getting issues with my Radeon 7 where after a while it will become very glitchy and slow across the whole computer until I restart, which fixes it. This wasn't an issue at all with my Vega 64. Yes, Radeon 7 support came to macOS in 10.14.6. I mean the final support. But most people think all vendors of the Radeon 7 are the same, like the PowerColor, MSI and so on. No, they are not. I see a lot of people have problems with the non-Sapphire version. As I say, I strictly recommend to my audience only components I personally tested and verified. I verified the Sapphire one to be the best one. Maybe if you cannot buy it, you can try to buy the other ones. But the Sapphire one, it's a choice number one. Bruce Cassidy, amazing as usual. You continue to inspire. I wish every success to you. Thank you very much, Bruce. Ethereal Sadness, your work is really important. Keep going. I'm trying. If you will still support me, I will continue. Subwitz, Morgonau, thank you for your help. Also, I want you to recommend me the best setup you have made up to now. Again, it's a comment under my 14-core iMac Pro Killer Hackintosh build. That's the best one I've built, darling. Truly Metal, internal GPU not showing at minute 5 and 5 seconds, and Intel QuickSync not working as seen at 10 minutes when exporting the data. RX 580 taking it all to render. Why is it so? That's because you didn't configure your GPU correctly. Easy like this. By the way, if you are listening here me the minutes, I'm not allowed to watch my own videos on YouTube, so I have no idea what is at 5 minutes and 5 seconds. So next time please try to tell it to me in detail. Gold Brick, Kauko Teresa, again. Do you think I speak all languages on planet? No, sorry. Please use English. Kraken. How to install Mojave without Mac? That's quite a common question. I've done 2 videos about it, how to do it from within Windows. But what happened? Apple didn't like it and took my videos 2 times down. Give me strike on my YouTube channel. So sorry, I will not release that videos again. But it's possible. Hakan Sten, hi, can you make a UEFI laptop Hackintosh guide? MacBook D, blah 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 blah. Have issues connecting? Of course you will have issues. That's why I say in my beginner's tutorial, don't do it on laptop. Forget it. Much more compatible are the desktop builds. So if you are a newbie, don't start with the laptop. It's really a very bad idea. Jonathan Castro, great video as always. However, I don't get the 14 cores. Isn't it 16, 8 cores, 16 threads for the 9900K? Please use your brain. 14-core iMac Pro is my build killer. So even my i9-9900K, only with 8 cores, can crash or kill the 14-core Apple iMac Pro. You get it now? TAG Media. Every day that has a new Morgonaut video is a good one. Okay, thank you very much. No name CV37. Morgonaut, I was of the belief that using Apple to update a Hackintosh was a risk. Any ideas, please? As I told you already on the beginning, all my builds are vanilla builds. They have no problem to update through official Apple servers. Oh, it's too long. Ben McPhee, Morgonaut, I just don't know if it's a good idea to attack your subscribers for not having seen all of your videos. I haven't seen all of anyone's videos. I never watched a Linus TT video until this week. I think it's great that you answer your comments, but this is the second time you answered one of mine and you seemed pissed off then too. If you said, I have an amazing video about virtualization, have a look at the video called blah blah blah, then I have been very grateful. Instead, I feel kind of annoyed. Linus has almost 9 million subscribers. You have 17,000. And he publishes his first. And his video title is quite honestly better. Run macOS on any PC. Of course, I watched his. I missed yours. I will watch it. I would have watched it by now, but I'm replying to you. It's not personal. Blah, blah, blah. Darling, Linus really released his video about 9-10 days before I released my video. But you forget, I was working on this solution few months. You get it? Okay. And if you will ask a stupid way, of course I will be pissed off. Hi, Teresa. Sorry. Marco Facio. Facio, I don't know, sorry. Hi, Teresa, thank for your help here. Which is the best option for a Thunderbolt 3 motherboard working out of the box? Or with very little and easy configuration? There is nothing like working out of the box from the PC world. You need to tweak it. That's why the EFI configuration that is there. So, if you really want the best motherboard with onboard native Thunderbolt 3 working out of the box, then choose the board I recommend, the Z390 Designare, and download my tweaked EFI folder. Then it's really out of the box. Mohamed Faki. Really, I am a big fan of you. First, I learned many things about Hackintosh, but your tutorials was the easiest way to build a perfect hack. Second, I know that there is no better than vanilla installation, because I used the Niresh custom hack that was terrible when trying to modify anything because it's full of kernel and kext patches, and I also think it's not safe. You just made an extremely hard vanilla way very easy for me. Third, your way to explain things is enjoyable. Your videos is really interesting. Thank you. Love from Egypt. Yes, this is true. Simply, if you want to have a perfect Hackintosh, you should always go with the vanilla way. If you don't know what does it mean, the vanilla Hackintosh installation, then watch my beginner's guide. I explain there everything. It's simply the cleanest way. Vanilla means that my system, when you have the macOS installed, is absolutely the same as on any real Mac. So if I will, for example, take a SSD out of my iMac over there or MacBook, I will just copy my EFI folder, tweaked EFI folder to the hidden EFI partition. I will throw it into this Hackintosh, this, any of those Hackintoshes, and it will simply work perfectly. The same in the opposite way. When I will take out the disk from my 14-core iMac Pro Killer build and connect to any real Mac, it will simply work as expected, because I'm using vanilla system. That means that the system itself is intact and absolutely the same. There are no changed files, the system files. All the, which I say the Hackintosh magic, is done only on the small hidden EFI partition. So always go the vanilla way. Matt Salomone. Hi, Teresa. Was hoping you could do a video on upgrading hardware only, without wiping previous Hackintosh drive. I'd like to update to this setup from an i7 Z97GB Hackintosh, but don't want to start from scratch. Thanks. Matt, yes, it's absolutely doable. So all you need to do is just delete your current EFI folder and replace it with the EFI folder tweaked for your new hardware setup. Easy like this. Christian Noir, your links for US buyers to buy the cooler Leos 2 NZXT, but only dual fan. Should we get the dual fan or triple fan? Yeah, initially I was recommending for my 14-core iMac Pro Killer the Ice Bear 360 liquid cooling. But I had, after a while, some issues with it, so that's why I replaced those links to that NZXT Kraken X62. But don't underestimate it. The Ice Bear has 360 fans, the NZXT has 280, but it's more powerful. So I strongly recommend take the Kraken X62. Kyle Aungerer. Damn, love the accent, very interesting review. Thank you. There is a lot of people who hate my accent, so I don't care. Just picker, this video would be over a million views if you didn't hide the process under paywall. Also, it would increase your subs and put Linus to shame. If you want to be a tech queen, you really need to release a how-to video on the process, otherwise someone else will. You said it yourself, this is the future. Darling, I'm not trying to be a tech queen. I am a Morgonaut. And I don't care about any millions of views. You simply don't understand simple fact. This virtualization solution I am doing for people remotely. Why? Because each build is different. Each client's needs are different. So there is no way how to do a single easy to do tutorial. Everybody would understand it. Each installation takes me about 4 to 5 hours. Do you really want me to do a video 5 hours long? You would watch it? I don't think so. Ve kunt Aurora. Teresa, thank you for helping me out with my first build. You're welcome. White Horse Ministries. Morgonaut, thanks a lot for responding. I'm a total ignorant about this matters, so I am trying to literally follow your instructions. After clicking Clover and Coffee Lake sample config, I scroll down and don't find the raw paste data section. I don't really understand the explanations. Darling, my video is about, 8 months old, I think, don't know. But the page you are referring, but which I am referring in that video description, is still the same, but they just slightly changed the layout of the page. So when I say in the video the raw paste, the data section is on the right top, now it's probably on the left bottom. So just read. White Horse Ministries again. Does creating a High Sierra boot installer need an additional line in the terminal command, application path or something? Again, the same example. Darling, exactly in this video description, I pasted all terminal commands for Mojave, High Sierra and older operating systems. So all you need to do is just read carefully my video description. Craig AK, Rip, Linus and Anthony, she is the future. That's nice. Metal Lord, hello, I have just came across your channel and have decided to subscribe. Your content is absolutely amazing and the depth that you are going into is just as amazing. I'm glad I have subscribed to your channel. I looked forward to your latest content. Keep up the great work. Thank you very much. Aryong Cute, is it possible to update 10.14 to 10.14.6? Yes, it is. Use exactly this video tutorial and follow it exactly in detail. Then you should have no problems to update it 10.14 to 10.14.6. Foral788. Grandma started build Hackintosh. It looks like idiot started comment under my videos. Axel Brito. Realistically, could this render 1080p video 60fps in a reasonable time frame? It's under i5-8400 CPU? Darling, this can do even 4K. But if you are subscribed to my second YouTube channel, I've proven that even on old prehistoric 2009 Apple Mac Mini, I was able to edit and render 4K videos. So this is beast against the 2009 iMac Mac Mini. Igor Soidl. Hi Morgonaut, first of all, thank you for your videos and effort. I don't want absolutely disappoint you, but your Hackintosh install method doesn't work in my case. I followed your advices and I repeated the process many times, but the installation process stopped after a few lines in Clover and I never reached the point where the language settings came. My PC is this, blah blah blah. Igor, that's exactly why I'm doing my videos and my builds. I cannot make it easier for people. Just buy this, so hardware I recommend, download this, that means my tweaked EFI for that particular build, and I guarantee in 15 to 30 minutes you will have your Hackintosh up and running in 100% condition and absolutely compatible. So all you need to do is just follow my videos. You chose the hard way. So enjoy it, but you can go the easiest way to go with Morgonaut. Next comment. Beavis Butthead. Okay, while this video is a tremendous help, I have watched it 3 times and at no time you show where to get the Hack Utils folder and its contents, nor did you ever show copying them to the bootloader USB drive. So I'm off to see where I can find those utils. This is absolutely most often question I'm getting under my videos. And now imagine after so many thousands of these comments, I'm really pissed off to answer that all again and again. That's why are those comments there, so you should read it before you ask. So I have also prepared answer which I just copy and paste to everybody when I have some free time. And the answer is, all the time same question, I answered that here in comments 1,000 times. Nobody read comments before post. I wonder why. People, please, use your brain. If you look carefully what contains that folder, you must understand that Hack Utils is folder randomly named by me and contains only files downloaded during this video. Do the same and you will have your own Hack Utils folder. Okay? Next question. Greg Bester. Excellent. I am getting this motherboard almost the same build. Where can I find your EFI folder again? So please read video description. That's all you need. I really spend a lot of time editing and tweaking my video description to be perfect. So all you need to do, just read it. Read it. AVG Vet. Morgonaut, now if only you had a tutorial for fixing Bluetooth. There is no need for tutorial about fixing Bluetooth. Simply buy compatible hardware. That's all. Then it's going to work out of the box. Food Tech Life. Are you using the green version of Resolve? The studio version is much, much faster. So Food Tech Life, darling, I have the studio version. I'm using it on my main production machine and also on some other builds. But I cannot agree that the studio version is much, much faster. No, it is not. It's absolutely the same. You are only missing some features which maybe most of the people have no idea what they are for. So, by the way, on my second YouTube channel, I am preparing quite a lot of videos about video editing. So if you are not subscribed, do it. Again, AVG Vet. Thank you, this actually worked for me. It's under my video how to fix iMessage. A lot of people don't have this working. A lot of people do. Where's the difference? They don't follow my tutorials and advices exactly. This video, by the way, has only 5 simple steps. And I have one master of universe who made 17 mistakes in those simple 5 steps. So please, if you are sure you are doing it right and following right, no, please, carefully, slowly do exactly what I say. Oh God, RPWDR Ligue. Hi, so I just want to make sure because I just bought this motherboard, will I need to buy a Wi-Fi card to make Wi-Fi work? Thanks and nice videos, by the way. Yeah, this motherboard, under which video you are commenting, does not have any Wi-Fi. You need to buy a Wi-Fi and Bluetooth compatible hardware. Again, as I said already, I am preparing video about it. What's the best for Hackintosh? White Horse Ministries. Can High Sierra be installed in the same way? Yes. My beginner's tutorial you can use to install Mojave and High Sierra. The principle is absolutely the same. Igor K. I think it's just easier to launch macOS through VirtualBox if you have powerful enough PC. No, that's not a solution. VirtualBox is a software virtualization. All I do on my virtualization builds are pure hardware, bare metal virtualization. The difference in the performance is absolutely night and day. Rajesh Nayak. Hey, I see a photo of Indian woman in the background. I was just curious who it could be. Okay, you mean this? So this is Mother Mera. I was visiting her about 6-7 times and getting darshans. She lives in Germany and of course, yes, she's from India. Mother Mera. Next question. David Valence, how do you get Thunderbolt 3 on Hackintosh? As I said, the most easiest way is to go with my highly recommended Gigabyte Z390 Designare motherboard. Links to it you can find in quite each of my video descriptions. It has native Thunderbolt 3 on board, and I already posted several EFI folders, mean tweaked EFI configurations, which makes this Thunderbolt 3 on this motherboard working out of the box for you. M.Blom. Morgonaut, I really do not understand you. What I hear is that your voice is very thin and ill. That could be better in a way, but if you are satisfied with it, okay, no biggie. Very thin and ill. Okay, maybe I'm ill. I cannot do anything with my voice. Sorry, that's how I was born. If you don't like it, don't watch my videos. Easy. Richilek. Morgonaut, ignore a non-audio professional's view and please continue with your work. So, it's another answer to previous question. Richilek again. Your tutorials are the best Macintosh tutorials out there by far. Keep up the good work. Only one small issue is the mic quality. Any plans for little upgrade? Either way, awesome videos. So, darling, I'm recording simultaneously to two condenser mics. Quite expensive, so it's not a problem of the hardware. As one before said, my voice is thin and ill. Okay, I was born that. Deal with it. Paul Marco Polo. My EFI disk appears to be empty. You mean probably EFI partition? And if it's empty, then you are not following my video tutorial exactly and carefully. You have to just copy the EFI folder configuration there. Larry Baker. I have a question. Do Apple support NVIDIA anymore? In my past experience, AMD cards has always been a nightmare for me to set up and I couldn't get any help. So, AMD cards are for long years in all Apple computers. No NVIDIAs anymore. NVIDIA support in macOS Mojave is still present, but for Kepler generation cards, not for newer ones. AMD cards are simply running amazing. I have no idea why you say it has been a nightmare for me to set up. No, it's running perfectly. Oh, it's long. Arben Man, I'm so grateful to Teresa for her hard work and dedication towards helping others have an affordable Mac experience. If you are wondering whether or not to embark on this project, let me tell you it's worth it. A few things to consider. This should not be seen as an experimental project. Teresa clearly lists the parts you need, so keep it simple and choose those exact components. If you have particular needs for your personal setup, talk to her first about it. I highly suggest supporting her on her Patreon site in order to get the required files and personal support if needed. In the end, it is a very small price for the final result. During our one-on-one Skype session, I quickly realized how much time and effort she puts into her work, so it's unfair to think her time is free. Watch her tutorials and read her Patreon posts. She clearly and precisely lays out every step. Most answers to questions can be found there. If you do get stuck on anything, she is there to help. I simply wanted to write about my personal experience because I think Teresa deserves the positive recognition for her efforts. Hopefully my post helps someone out in deciding. Thank you very much, Arben Man. That's exactly what I said. All you need to do is just watch my videos, read video descriptions, and follow my advices. Then you will never get into trouble with your Hackintosh. Jason Baden. Hi, I am in the process of switching to Mac. I purchased a MacBook Pro and was waiting until the new Mac Pro release in the fall to take advantage of the Intel Xeon Scalable, with the updated hardware. Honestly, the starting price is scary. I am looking at and considering building this 14-core i9 Hackintosh you have configured and developed. Do you have or can you recommend a Xeon build for use with CAD development? Is the i9 system you build here comparable on ongoing Xeon? Is just a waste of money. I just want fast. macOS definitely has that. Any help is appreciated. Jason, quite interesting question. Yeah, Xeons are the enterprise CPUs. Most, I think 99% of people out there have no idea what is AVX 512 instruction set. So if you have to ask, you don't need it. In 99.999% of cases, the i9-9900K will be the fastest CPU you can get, and it will be as easy to build one as I told you in my videos, 15 to 30 minutes. Xeon will not give you any other benefit, otherwise it's going to be much more expensive. You would need to go with different platform, X versus the ordinary or common Z platform. So total cost would be three times higher, and the performance the same. So i9-9900K and my 14-core iMac Pro Care is far the best what you can get for your money. Scott Luther, 615. It's a shame that Apple doesn't create a better way to create a bootable OS installer flash drive instead of having to use command lines instructions in terminal. Another guy who is afraid of terminal. By the way, I think this way in the terminal is the absolute best way how to do it. Kanson, working perfect. Another one who has no problem to make using my tutorial how to fix iMessage, working iMessage. A lot of people have problems and we already know why. Sachin Nair, I follow the steps exactly as you said, but it doesn't work for High Sierra. I get an error saying you cannot sign into iMessage on this Mac at this time. So exactly what I was talking previously. Darren Basile, have you tried making a Hackintosh from Intel NUC Hades Canyon? Darren, no, I don't have any Intel NUC Hades Canyon. If you want some tutorial about it, send me one, I can do it. Alessandro Spedito, hi, how is possible to receive help for virtualization? Yeah, no problem, just reach me at my Patreon or my Subscribestar and we can discuss it in detail, and that remotely I can do everything for you, set up in front of your eyes, whenever you are around this planet. I've done, I don't want to say hundreds, but quite really, really a lot of builds like this already. At your service, good work Teresa, thank you. My Mint 76, tough Z390 plus gaming Wi-Fi BIOS setup, please. Mr. My Mint 76, do you think I will now go to first PC parts shop and buy tough Z390 plus gaming Wi-Fi just to make a video about BIOS because you want it? Sorry, no. Oh, that's all. By the way, I have here some more interesting stuff here which I left at the end, and it's quite nice. What's better than gaming PC, Macintosh, Hackintosh or Linux build? So much better than the Linus video. Sorry Linus, I will get this next year and definitely contact you. Another comment, Petr thinks I like. This is a stunning video. I hope Linus Tech Tips saw it because he hell could learn something from it. Yes, Linus' solution is far more complicated and far behind my solution. I am always here to help. Ralph Miranda, thank you so much. This vanilla install video is and easy enough to follow. I got my Hackintosh working last night. I didn't even want to look at it for weeks and I decided to follow your video. No other tutorial got me up and running. That's exactly how my build works. Simply, it's easy. You know, a lot of people ask me, what are good resources on internet? Where should I find some help? There are a lot of forums like, okay, let's say it, Olarela, Tony Mac crap, Insanely Mac, some Reddit forums and so on. But if you are smart, please don't go there. There are only a bunch of stupid idiots massaging their egos. That's all. They really don't want to honestly help. They also banned me out of all those forums because I was trying to help. So, best resource? Sorry, Morgonaut. Let's be honest. So, that was exactly 90 questions and answers. If I didn't answer exactly your question, feel free to comment under any of my videos and maybe next time I will answer also your question. So, I hope I brought again a little bit of light to your homes. If so, please click on the like button below. Click also the share button so more people can benefit from it. Subscribe to my channel and hit the bell next to it so you won't miss any of my future videos. And if you will have some problems with your computer, feel free to anytime get my personal individual support on my Patreon or Subscribestar. Links are now in this video description. Morgonaut is always here to help. So, that's all for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time, my friends.